finally to Rachel. She told me I wasn't allowed to call her stunning. So I guess you look good or something. I don't know, mate. Right, yeah. She said, stunning, so what did you say? I don't know. She said, yeah, everyone says calls you stunning, so I'm not going to call her stunning. She looks good. Rachel and I probably argue like no one I've ever argued with before. She's stubborn. I'm stubborn. She's smart. I'm smart. She's funny. I'm funnier. We talk about random stuff. We talk about politics. She didn't know which way. I always tell her we're right wing. She thinks we're left wing.
This is just what the doctor ordered for Rachel, because sometimes she has a bit of spirit about her, if you know what I mean. Yeah. It might be in the DNA anyway. I don't know. Anyway, the combination works well. Seriously, Rachel's a heart of gold and helps anyone she can whenever she can. And we're very proud of her and love her very much. When Rach was a little girl, she always wanted to play weddings with me. And she'd get all dressed up and we'd have this ceremony. We'd walk down the passage and I'd be singing, "Here comes the bride, all shiny and bright, she looks beautiful tonight." Then we'd get to the end of the passage and she'd marry her teddy. Anyway, tonight she's married Ryan, and we couldn't be happier. Rach and Ryan make a great couple. They're both very hard workers, setting themselves up, and we admire that in them. Wish them all the happiness and good luck in the world for the future together.
To Ryan, Jane and I were trying to think what to say about you. Jane had a few adjectives that I can't really. But seriously, the easiest way to explain it is that we are so proud of you. And you know that our whole family loved you and always will. Ryan's biggest attribute, is, in my eyes, is his loyalty and his caring of his mates. I've known those guys all my life, and we're in the house today. And I probably shouldn't say this, but they love each other. You can see. The only thing they don't do is sleep together. Well, they have done that too.
Rachel, you know me better than anyone else in this world, and somehow you still manage to love me. You're my best friend and one true love. I cannot believe how lucky I am that I'm the one who gets to marry you today. I know sometimes I don't always show how much you mean to me, but you're my best friend, and being with you makes me such a better person. You can be pretty annoying at times, but I still love you the mostest. You give me the biggest smiles every day, and I couldn't imagine my life without you. Thanks for all the memories over the last 6 years. I'm so excited for our future together when I become an old man with a young hot wife. I can't wait to start a family with you and have a little sugar. I want to call my baby Sugar. She doesn't really approve, but I know you'll be the best wife and mum I could have ever hoped for. I promise to be understanding, faithful and honest. I promise to continue to work hard to support our love, lifestyle, and family. I'll always want the best for you, and I'll be your biggest supporter. I love you, babe. Always for it.
Ryan, when I first met you, I had no idea how much my life was about to change. It's clear to me now that everything in my life has led me to you. I think back on all my choices and consider even the bad ones worth it, because if I had done one thing differently, I might never have met you and become your wife. A love like ours happens once in a lifetime. When we fell in love, I realised that what I always thought was happiness couldn't compare to the pure joy you brought me. Because of you, I smile and laugh every single day. You are and always will be the love of my life, my soulmate, my very best friend. From this day forward, I vow to be your faithful and loving wife. I promise to care for you, support you, and reassure you in times of need. I will no doubt continue to annoy you when you want to go to bed early, steal your jokes, pay out your facial expressions, and wipe the kitchen sink 50 times after every use. But I'll continue to love, honour, and respect you for all the days of my life. I can't wait to become a mum and to watch you become a dad, because I know that together we'll fill our family home with so much happiness. I love you, babe.
Slow dance on a New York City horizon.
I ask everyone here to witness that I, Ryan, take you, Rachel, to be my lawful wedded wife. I give you this ring as a symbol of all that I have and all that I am.
I ask everyone here to witness that I, Rachel, take you, Ryan, to be my lawful wedded husband. I give you this ring as a symbol of all that I have and all that I am. He's got a fat finger.
By the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Australia, it gives me great pleasure to declare you husband and wife. Make this your bride. Let's make some noise as I introduce to you for the very first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Starr.
Probably the best parents-in-law I could ask for. When I first went to... Actually, when I first met up with Rachel, I was told that I was never allowed in the house. And then somehow, I've become the best son-in-law. The first time we had dinner, obviously we're drinking beers, because that's what they do. And Rachel said to me, you've got to drive home soon. Like, when are you going to go home? And of course, they said, he knows the back roads. He'll be right. So we just kept drinking.
I think we need to take a moment to appreciate all the hard work that went into setting up tonight. So Rachel, well done. You've done an amazing job.
and everyone else that helped. And no doubt Ryan probably did something. Yeah, he rocked up. But Rach, you look amazing. The bridesmaids look amazing. And the guys look presentable, which is good. Now, I promised Ryan my speech wouldn't go for any longer than he does in the bedroom, which probably means that I've gone too long already. But I hope that, unlike Ryan, at least everyone will be happy at the end of this speech.
We're not calling us on sugar.
Still can't believe my good mate Ryan Stoke actually got married today. And to a woman. Like, who would have thought? Having said that, I am, however, very glad and grateful it's to the beautiful person standing right next to him. Sitting. Rachel, you're extremely brave. Out of your own free will, you decided to marry the most stubborn person I know. But if anyone can change that, it's definitely you. To be honest, you've been the best thing that has ever happened to Ryan. And he is one lucky guy to have found such a caring, patient and understanding person as you. So thank you for loving our mate Ryan as much as we all do. And I'll be ever grateful that you came into his life and his friend's life.
When I first started going to Rachel's house, Phil's a gamer, and all I used to hear from Phil's bedroom was fuck, fuck, shit, shit, help, help. And I used to say to Rachel, what's he doing? And she's like, he's just on his game, don't worry about it. And I'd never seen him for about probably the first 6 months, but then eventually finally came out of his room, and it's good to finally have a brother, Phil. I love you too. A little closer, let me taste your smile until the morning light. Ain't no going back the way you look tonight. I see it in your eyes.